Well, let's talk about charter schools gone wild, Chris. What is this about?
Well, Bob, we often hear when a teacher has been misbehaving or doing something inappropriate, the response is, well, most teachers aren't like that. Most schools aren't like that. That's just a few bad apples. You can't judge them all that way. And that's fair, right?
Sure.
Yeah, but apparently that same logic doesn't really apply to charter schools, at least according to this recent study.
I see. In this realm, anecdotes can actually just be the message.
Yeah, have a look.
It's charters gone wild. These charter schools are completely out of control. One study from two groups called Integrity in Education and the Center for Popular Democracy even suggests that waste, fraud, and abuse, things that would never, ever possibly occur in district schools, have in fact occurred in charters. Kyle Surrett at the Center for Popular Democracy gave this official statement. We are very dismayed to have found $100 million in fraud and lost taxpayer dollars. That's just in 15 states. And that figure fails to capture the real harm to children. Clearly, we should hit the pause button on charter expansion until there is a better oversight system in place to protect our children and our communities.
Quote, Ms. Smith started to perform a full contact lap dance, court documents read.
Our school system exists to serve students and enrich communities, added Sabrina Stevens, the director of Integrity in Education. School funding is too scarce as it is. We can hardly afford to waste the resources we do have on people who would prioritize exotic vacations over school supplies or food for children. Well, that pretty much sums it up. We simply can't risk bad things happening in charter schools. Our only choice is to rein in the choices given to parents, so their kids can remain in highly successful district schools, where they might be free from the fears of fraud, mismanagement, and waste.
All right. Well, in fact, I wanted to riff on this in much the similar vein you did, Chris, in your piece, which is that, to open up the other page of my browser here, this is the news coverage about the charter schools gone wild, mm-hmm. and they have these bullet points here, right? And so, much as you did, so I noticed here, charter schools operators using public funds illegally, outright embezzlement. They're actually going to categorize the problems and mismanagement in charters, right? Number one, outright embezzlement. So I looked up, you mean like this? Former North Pike School District pleads guilty to embezzlement in Mississippi, a regular district school. Item number two, using tax dollars to illegally support other non-educational business. That sounds awful, right?
Yeah.
Like this, California Federation of Teachers using union money to fix the healthcare crisis, their advocacy for single-payer healthcare. One might argue is not purely an educational priority, like non-educational business. How about bullet point three, mismanagement that puts children in potential danger? Children could actually be in danger. I feel your concern. Like this, lead paint at Portland schools raises concern. Children could even be in danger at a district school, maybe, dare I say. I don't know. It goes on and on. Charters illegally taking public dollars for services they didn't provide. Oh, you mean this guy who pled guilty to stealing field trip money? Services, I guess, the school didn't provide? Etc. So, boy, it's a tale of two types of schools, isn't it, Jason? In terms of where, you know, anecdotes for charters, to charter opponents, all you need is a few anecdotes, and you've indicted the entire sector. Whereas with district schools, we can have hundreds and thousands of anecdotes, and they always say, well, that doesn't mean it's all of us.
You're absolutely right. I mean, I had an opportunity to glance over that report this afternoon, and that is really what it seems like, is just nothing but a series of the worst case anecdotal stories that they could possibly find in some of these schools. I paid particular attention to the notes that it made on Ohio, the two schools that they said where the students were put in danger. And what they seem to spin it in such a way, they fail to point out that the superintendent's comments were made because the state intervened and shut down that school. Something like that happens right in a public school. I don't think that the state is going to be stepping in there and shutting the public school down.
Right.
So you're absolutely right. I think that, you know, all that report illustrates is just a series of worst case anecdotal stories, and it fails to take a look at a lot of the good work that charter schools are doing for students in their communities.
Right. And just to tag it with this, you know, this is the Integrity for Education, the group that put out that anti-charter report. This is their website. I was just kind of looking at it earlier, kind of seeing what's on there. And I saw this post from March 26th, Truthiness and Lies. And I clicked on it and it says, we all make mistakes, but when we're honest, we admit them. So far, Jeb Bush's Foundation for Excellence in Education has done the exact opposite. The part I wanted to point out is that they actually use the goofy photo of Jeb Bush. Like, you don't get much more hackery, you know, in the realm of hackery, whatever the right noun is, than to when you are disparaging someone, you try to find a goofy looking photo of them. And it's like, oh, wow, we didn't realize they're that bad. But what a loser. Look, he's got a weird face on right there in that photo. This is actually the style of the presentation of the group Integrity in Education. I would argue not necessarily integrity in photo editing for their website.
Not exactly.
Kind of a joke there. So Jason Ward, before we let you go, in the tradition we've had lately with people coming to us from states whose governors might be president, you think Governor Kasich might run in 2016? What are your thoughts on that?
I am not the type of person who would ever discount any possibility.
What a political answer. Has
made it very well known, though, that his sole focus right now is on his reelection campaign. It's actually primary day here in Ohio, so we're about halfway through the process.
He'll win the Republican primary for his.
I have a pretty good feeling that he will be emerging victorious this evening.
Right.
But that's really been his sole focus. But he's run once before. He did run in 2000 when he left Congress.
That's right.
So I wouldn't discount anything.
Is he going to New Hampshire or Iowa or anything like that in press, giving a couple speeches out there? Any indication of that? Do you know?
I know he recently made the trip that a lot of the potential candidates made out to Las Vegas. But that, to my knowledge, really is the only one that he has made. He's largely been focusing on issues here at home.
All right.
I do know our senator is out there making some similar trips as well. So yeah, I think we've got two potential presidential or vice presidential candidates here in Ohio.
You heard it here first. Jason Warner declaring the candidacy of John Kasich for president in 2016. Thank you for your time today on Reform School. Jason Warner of the Legislative and Policy Director of School Choice Ohio. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
All right. And for Chris and Heather and Allison and whoever else might be here today, I'm Bob Bowden. We'll see you next time.